What's up, guys? Welcome to another week of Youth Church Online, where we want to help you develop healthy community online in this season, experience the love of God, and also receive helpful teaching for life. So let's check out what we got going on this week. Well, we've got lots of great stuff coming up tonight. We've got the Send It Challenge, which has been so fun. We've got Rayanne leading us in worship, and then we've got Matt, who's going to be sharing a really encouraging word. And I'm just praying that wherever you're watching from tonight, that God just speaks to you, that your heart is encouraged, and that, of course, you'll join in on a Zoom small group after this video. So I'm just going to pray, and then we're going to head into worship. Father, I just thank you so much for just the opportunity to do youth online, even when we can't be together, God. And I just pray that through this video, you will speak to hearts and that we will feel united and connected in you, even from a distance, God. So we just pray for this service tonight, God, and just pray that, that you would just speak to us all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, hey, everyone. It's so awesome to be able to do worship with you guys this week. We really miss being here in the building, but we're still glad that we can gather online. And so why don't you just enter into worship with us? We're going to do some songs that are familiar to you, and so you can just sing along and engage. Freedom is an open door. You are everything.
going, everyone? My name's Matthew. I'm a grade 12 student here at BP Youth. I'm a student leader, so you may have seen me around helping out and stuff. Before I get into everything, I just want to applaud you guys, seriously. Tuning in every Friday, even at home, that's a big deal, so congratulations, I guess. You get to listen to me, so you guys are being faithful, and I really believe God has something in store for you every single time you guys tune in and listen to these live streams, so mad props. So I don't know about you guys, but lately I've had the urge to just kind of like get outside, get away from my family, so I'm doing this outside. I have a biker hill behind me, so if you hear screaming, no one's being murdered. That's just kids whipping it down the hill. So I have a little story to share before we get too deep. So I had the itch to get outside, like I said before, and the opportunity arose. I got to go take some photos with one of my friends, so it was pretty sick. I had this whole fit worked out. I was like, I got new shoes, so I was ready to kick it. And we drive out to this place, and in the Country Hills hood, we call it Split Rock. So it's this rock that was split by lightning, supposedly. I'm not sure if I believe it. But the rock was split in half. So we went out there. We were like, yo, this is so cool. Let's check it out. So we climb up this rock. We're like taking photos. We got some sick photos. So anyways, we're on top of this rock, and we're taking these good photos. And then all of a sudden it occurs to me, I'm like, yo, I'm on this rock. And you look down, it's like this 10-foot drop. And I know 10 feet doesn't seem like a lot to you, but I'm like horrified of heights, right? So I'm the guy that passed out on the Disneyland ride, the Guardians of the Galaxy one, where it like drops you. Ask Hunter or Aaron about it. They were there. So seriously, I'm like horrified of heights. So I'm like sitting up there, I'm freaking out, having like a serious anxiety attack. Anyways, I'm having a serious anxiety attack. I'm like, I'm not getting down. And Nathan and Aaron, my brother and Aaron, are like, come on, Matt, like you got it, man. Just jump off. And I'm like literally standing there like paralyzed for like 10 minutes just sitting there. Like, heights are my number one fear. If we were in the middle of a zombie apocalypse, not corona apocalypse, I wouldn't even care, as long as there's nothing that I have to jump off of that's more than 3 feet. But if you ask me to do any of that, I'm not doing it. I'd rather get eaten by zombies than jump off a rock or my deck or literally anything that's more than 3 feet, like I said. So I was like sitting on top of this rock. I didn't know. I was like, I don't want to jump off because I don't want to die from fall damage. And I don't want to like stay up there because I might like choke out from not enough oxygen. So I'm sitting there like contemplating. My brother and Aaron are like, come on down, come on, man. So I'm sitting there. I'm like, Nathan, cue up Oceans right now on Spotify. Like, hey, Siri, Oceans now. Ocean starts playing. I'm like swaying back and forth. I'm just vibing out, right? And I'm like, okay, this is it. This is the time I'm gonna jump. So Oceans plays. As soon as the chorus hits, I like jump off. I jump across the rock and then down. So it was like, really, it was just like a jump across like a foot gap and then like a half foot drop down, but I was still horrified. So I was like screaming like a little girl. And as soon as I was down, I like looked up at the rock and I was like, you gotta be kidding me, man. Like, what am I even scared of? There's literally nothing. It wasn't that big of a deal, but I made it so much worse than it needed to be, truly. And that, as I was like reviewing for the sermon after Hunter asked me to do it, I was like, what am I gonna talk about with all this COVID stuff? So the story kind of made me think about this whole situation that's going on right now. Like, to be completely honest, I've been like losing my mind a little bit, like worrying about my future. Like, stay up till 1 a.m. thinking in my bed, I'm like just listening to some music, and all I can think about is, where's my future going? Like, how is this going to affect my future? Am I going to get into a university? Are they going to accept my grades? Stuff like that. So I've been like worrying sick about it. But this kind of story, like, whenever you're at the top of the rock, you're always so worried about what's going to happen. And like, are you going to survive? Are you going to make it? But I just had this Bible verse that I was searching out Bible verses about this kind of stuff. And Proverbs 23:18 came up. So if you have your Bibles or on your phone, don't close out of the tab, but Proverbs 23:18 says, "Sure, there is surely a future hope for you, and your hope will not be cut off." So to me, this verse is like a promise from God that he's like, there is still future hope for you. Like, no matter what you're going through, no matter what kind of pandemic is like ravaging the earth, God still has a plan for us, and he's gonna bring it out. And another verse is John 16:33. God says, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I've overcome the world. So it's like, in these two verses, I just believe God's like taking life by the horns, as they say. And he's just like, I've beat it, man. I've been there, I've done that. And we don't have anything to worry about with this pandemic. So God is so much bigger than our fears. And he holds each of us in his hands, and under his protection, we carry out the plan he has on our lives. We carry out our calling with him, with our hedge of protection, as the parents say in prayers, around us, that he's protecting us with. And I feel like sometimes we let fear control us, and it causes us to be short-sighted, and we can't see the next 10 steps in front of us. It's like we have a lamp, but it's on dim. It's not bright enough to see more than 10 steps. But I believe that just turn up the lamp, man. Just have faith in God, and he'll lead you more than 20, 30 steps. He'll lead you a mile. He'll show you your future. Proverbs 12:25, it says that anxiety weighs down the heart. And I think that's so cool that the Bible uses like the word anxiety. It says that anxiety weighs down the heart. And for me, that's like, God's so relevant now. Like, even from then on till now and forever, he'll be relevant. And he knows that there's going to be times where we're worried sick about what our future is. So sometimes our fear and anxiety can make us feel paralyzed or stuck. And if there's one thing that I've been like reinforcing in my mind lately, is that God's not done yet. God has the power to overcome any obstacle in life, and the same power lives through us in the Holy Spirit. So the question I want to leave you guys with today, you can talk about it in small groups, Zoom call your friends, get some FaceTimes in here. Seriously, it will keep you sane. So the question I want to leave you guys with is, what fears or worries do you need to give to God so that you can be set free from them? What kind of stuff do you need to pass on to God so that he can take it off of you, and you don't have to worry about it anymore? So I'm going to pray real quick before you leave, and then we'll send you on your way. So, dear God, thank you so much for this day. I thank you that we still have online youth, and I pray that you bless everyone who tunes in to watch every Friday. You guys are seriously amazing. I pray safety over everyone. I pray that they keep their hygiene and their health. I thank you that we have so many opportunities now more than ever to spend time with you, and I want to thank you for that. Again, I pray that this whole coronavirus thing blows over fast, and that we can all stay safe in the meantime. And I pray that we can lift our worries to you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Well, guys, I hope that Matt's message was encouraging for you tonight. And if you take one thing away, I hope you remember that God is not finished with your story. He has purpose for your life. He has purpose for this season for you, and you can trust him with your future. So I'm just praying that that truth settles in on you this week, and that you have a great rest of your night. Now, without further ado, here comes the Send It Challenge.
Go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. You know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide, left foot up, right foot slide. Basically. You know, I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. Can't let this one slide.